We've all heard of the placebo effect, but did you know doctors sometimes create studies with a surgical placebo group where one group will actually get a fake surgery?
There have been studies where one group of patients will receive a placebo surgery. They're put under anesthesia, cut open, and stitched back together as though they had a real surgery, except no treatment was actually done. And at times, this is enough for a patient to actually feel better. The hope in doing these studies is to see if the surgery really works or if it just gives patients the placebo effect. The ultimate goal is to cut down on unnecessary procedures. Are these a good way to weed out which surgeries work, or is it putting people at risk for the sake of experiment?
Joining us via Skype is orthopedic surgeon Dr. Andrew Carr, who conducted a study with a placebo surgery group and advocate for transparency in medicine, surgeon and author of The Price We Pay, Dr. Marty McCary. Welcome to both of you doctors.
Hi.
You know, I'm really excited to talk about this. Our goal ultimately in medicine is to make it more efficient, to make it safer. Dr. Carr, can you just talk a little bit about what inspired you to conduct this study using a placebo arm?
We investigated a very commonly performed shoulder operation where a spur of bone is removed from part of the shoulder blade that surgeons for many years have felt was causing the cause of pain. But the difficulty we had was that we just didn't have the evidence to support this operation that had become the commonest shoulder operation in Europe and in the USA. So we decided to undertake a study. And it became clear when we were thinking about the study, talking to patients, talking to clinical trialists, talking to ethicists, that we really needed to see whether or not it was possible that there was a placebo effect in this surgery. And that required us to compare the real surgery with a group of patients having an anesthetic and an incision, but not having the spur removed.
Can you talk a little bit about how you enroll individuals in a study like this and who signs up for this?
And how do they sign up?
Well, they sign up through a process of informed consent. So very careful discussion is made with the patient. But before we got to that stage, we had to meet with ethicists, we had to meet with our ethical review board, we had to define exactly how we were going to describe the study to the patient.
And Dr. Carr, the placebo effect is anywhere from 15 to 72% in studies. And it's not just a perceived benefit. There are studies that have shown, for example, that asthma patients after taking a placebo pill will actually experience less constriction in their bronchial tubes. And so we're talking about a very real thing that may be happening that is for the greater good, because you could be preventing so many patients from having an unnecessary surgery that's not even effective for them.
Are they being reimbursed? Are they being compensated in some way?
No, so they aren't being reimbursed. They are part of the NHS treatment system. They don't pay for the surgery, the NHS pays for the surgery, and they don't get personally reimbursed.
If you agreed it was surgery and there's a chance that you're not having anything done whatsoever, isn't it assault and battery of sorts?
The view we took and the view we came to with our patient advisors and with our ethicists was that it was actually unethical not to do the trial, not to do the study. Mm-hmm. So in the United Kingdom, 30,000 of these operations were being performed a year before we did the study. We did the study, we showed that the outcome for the patient was no different between having the real surgery and having the placebo surgery. Mm-hmm. As a consequence of that study, rates of surgery have dropped to less than 3,000 per annum now.
So your study actually was able to prove that the actual surgery provided no benefit as compared to this placebo surgery. You saw a drop in surgeries in the UK.